Tonight, Rockline is pleased to welcome John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora of Bon Jovi. For your chance to interview these guys, call our toll-free AT&T number right now, 1-800-344-ROCK. That's 1-800-344-7625. One number toll-free from anywhere in the United States and Canada. Well, Bon Jovi celebrates their 10th anniversary this year with the release of Crossroad, a greatest hits collection that includes two brand new songs and a retooled version of a Bon Jovi classic. They're also working on a brand new album that should be out early next year, and Rockline is happy to welcome back to their sixth appearance on the show.
Wow.
Some old friends, John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora.
Good morning.
Hey, guys.
Good morning.
Well, in some time zones, perhaps. Great to have you guys back.
Thank you.
It's been way too long since your last visit, but we're thrilled to have you here.
Thanks.
John, it's certainly unusual for any band to stay together for 10 years with no personnel changes whatsoever. But considering the sort of bass-ackwards way that things came together for you and for the band in the very beginning, it must amaze even you that the chemistry that brought you guys together is still there after 10 years.
Well, it was a nice ride, too, you know, getting along with everybody for that 10 years and to mark that decade as
It was a nice ride for even you.
Even for me, I admit it. Yeah, it's been a great ride, you know. I mean, it really has. And just to think, I couldn't have made up stories like this.
Really?
You know what I mean? To think that we'd be where we are now and still enjoying it as much as we do. It's been great.
Richie, usually with a band, it's always the next album, the next tour. And I'm sure even now your focus is on the new album that you're working on that's going to be out sometime next year. But with a greatest hits collection like Crossroad is, it does kind of maybe force you to look back.
Absolutely. I think that greatest hits albums are transitional records, of course. Either that or they mark the end of your career. In this case, it's certainly not the end.
That's for sure.
In this case, it's the end of a decade, our first decade as a band together. I think it's like a musical scrapbook. Those hits and those songs have their memories for us, the band members, as though the listeners, too. You know, when I was a kid growing up, I'd always put on a record and it always remind me about a specific time in my life. Mm-hmm. So I think that's what greatest hits are all about.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There are two new songs, as I indicated, on this album, and I was wondering if these are an indication of where you're headed in terms of the new album, or were these things that you had, you know, sort of lying around or from other sessions?
Well, it's a difficult answer to give you honestly, but Always was written for a movie. I wrote it for a movie called Romeo is Bleeding. And as much as I love the title of the film, love the script, love the idea of doing something for a Gary Oldman movie, didn't really like the way it turned out at the end, and pulled the song and re-recorded it as a band. And it worked out so well to put it on this Greatest Hits project because there are only a couple of new songs, and it really gets its opportunity to shine, whereas on the next album, it'd be one of 15 songs. And so, you know, it really didn't necessarily fit on where we're going and what we feel we have.
We don't know where we're going.
Well, we'll figure it out sometime in the next.
We're just driving. We don't know where we're going. We're just kind of driving.
There's a song there called Someday It'll Be Saturday Night. It's a Monday night, and it feels like Monday nights with Bon Jovi on Rockline. Someday It'll Be Saturday Night, one of two new tracks on the Bon Jovi Greatest Hits collection called Crossroad. We'll be playing more from that, of course, and taking your phone calls. And a little bit later on, the guys are going to be playing live for us. So I would suggest you stay right where you are. And you also might want to get on the phone because we have 90 minutes with John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora. You got something you want to talk about or ask the guys, give us a call on our toll-free AT&T number, 1-800-ROCK. That's 1-800-344-7625. Rockline and AT&T, we help put your world within reach. Before we get to the phones, I'd like to take a minute to congratulate a couple of friends of ours on some well-deserved promotions. First, to our very good friend and buddy, Andre Gardner at 92.3 K-Rock in New York for being named the new program director there. Hope you enjoy the bubbly there, Andre. And also to Brent Haynes of B98 KFBD in Waynesville, Missouri, also for getting his PD stripes there. I'd like to thank both of you guys very much for your continued support of Rockline. And as always, we look forward to hearing from your listeners tonight and every Monday night on Interactive Radio Rockline. Richie Sambora, John Bon Jovi, our guests. Our first stop tonight is Bossier, Louisiana. KTAL 98 in Shreveport is our station there. Patricia?
Yeah.
You're on Rockline.
Hi. How y'all doing?
Hi, Patricia.
I was wondering, how do y'all choose what songs you're going to release off of a new album?
It's hard. You know, they're all like your favorites until you get into a studio and start playing them, and then you just see which ones sink and which ones swim.
Yeah, most of the time the cream comes to the crop, as they say.
What about choosing songs for Crossroad? Now, some would be obvious choices, you know, the singles and the hits and stuff.
Yeah,
like that,
you know, I mean, we've been so lucky through the years that there are certified top 10 singles that aren't on the record. You know, Living in Sin or Born to Be My Baby and Never Say Goodbye didn't make the record, you know, and it just became a situation where what we thought was going to be a no-brainer, you know, just throw them all on one record, only holds 78 minutes of music, and fortunately for us, we've had enough hits, certified hits through the years that it didn't fit.
Wow. Yeah, it's a really nice problem to
yeah,
have.
Really. That's all right. Patricia, thanks for getting started.
Hon. Thank you, Patricia.
Ryan is in Burlington, Texas tonight, listening to Q102 in Dallas. Hey, Ryan.
Hey, how you guys doing?
What's
Ryan.
Happening?
I was wondering if you're going to release a live album anytime soon.
Probably not, because there's such an abundance of new material, and then this greatest hits idea popped up, and what we've been, you know, for years we were saying, oh, yeah, we have this live album in the can. And then our manager reminded us that we've used them all as B-sides now. So, not in the near future, bud. Sorry.
There you go. Angie is in Barrie, Ontario, listening to Q107 up in Toronto tonight.
Hey.
Hi, guys.
I was just there.
Hi, Angie.
Hello.
My question for you guys is regarding the great music experience you guys did in Japan earlier this year. I was wondering if you guys want to talk about that.
Well, it was a very interesting kind of thing. There was a big orchestra that was there and a bunch of Japanese artists and a bunch of artists from all over the world that got together and just decided to put the music together. George Martin, who produced the Beatles, of course, was the producer on it. And John and I did a couple of acoustic tunes and also played with this great Japanese orchestra. And then there was this big Japanese drum section. It was quite an interesting multicultural musical experience.
The only thing I saw there was Bob Dylan.
That's right.
So we just like... two kids. I just sat there with a camera, and Bob came over, and he says, I like that cowboy song. And we're going, we're like high-five, and we look like Beavis and Butthead. We're like, totally. Bob Dylan thinks Wanted, you know, and we're going, this is great. We're doing like an acoustic version of Wanted, and then we'd bring Bob out, and they'd do this closing thing, you know, and he'd sing, and we'd all sing together, and man, it was so hip because I liked it.
Then we both took turns going up to the photographers in the front. Did you get that picture? Did you get the picture of me, John and Bob, man?
That's great. Nelson is in Casablanca, New Mexico, listening to 94 Rock in Albuquerque tonight. Nelson.
Hey, guys. How's it hanging?
How you doing, bud?
Hanging pretty good, Nelson.
Not too bad. My question is, the name of the album, Crossroads, does this signify a turning point in your career? For the best or for the worst?
Well, hopefully for the best, you know. I think we headed down a different path with Keep the Faith, and we just wanted to change direction and move upward and onward. And I think that Crossroads signifies that first decade that we're tipping our hat to, but moving on.
All right, Nelson, thanks.
Thank you.
John, you sort of, you alluded to doing One Dead or Alive acoustically over in Japan, and as I mentioned before, you brought the guitars.
Sure.
What do you
think? Is that our cue? Is that our cue?
That would be a cue.
I don't want to.
Sorry.
It's John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora live on Rockline tonight.
And Bob Dylan. And Bob Dylan, too, man. Yeah.
Oh, there you go. Here we go.
Two, three, four.
Same.
It seems we're wasting away. Another place where the fences are so cold. You drive all night just to get back home. I'm a cowboy on a steel horse I ride. Wanted, dead or alive. Wanted, dead or alive. Times I sleep, times I snap for days. People I meet come and then they go their separate ways. Sometimes I tell a day about a bottle that you drink. Sometimes you're all alone. All you do is think. I'm a cowboy on a steel horse I ride. Wanted, wanted, dead or alive. Wanted, wanted, dead.
Bon Jovi, Richie Sambora, live on Rock Line tonight. Wanted, dead or alive. Very, very nice, guys.
My headphones fell off, man.
Let's sort of get close to home here. Old Bridge, New Jersey is our next stop. Mike's listening to 92.3 K-Rock in New York this evening. Hey, Mike.
Hey, what's up, John and Richie?
What's up, Mike? What's up there, homie?
I'm sure we know this guy.
Hey, I wanted to know if you guys were interested in doing, like, songs for a tribute album for another band like Kiss did or Black Sabbath. And I was wondering also if you'd be interested in doing tribute songs for, like, charity, per se.
Well, we've done a few of those with the Special Olympics records for handicapped kids. We've done both of those albums. And
I did the Muddy Waters tribute record, and I just recently did a track for the Jimi Hendrix tribute record, some Jimi Hendrix.
But as far as other tributes planned...
How about you?
A tribute to me. How about you? Hey, we got a Bon Jovi tribute album going.
It's coming out next year, isn't it?
Hey, why not? You know what I mean?
There you go. Thank
I'd like to do some of those in the future, but I don't know. You know, there's not
what's
plan.
Coming up.
Yeah.
It would be good.
Any artist, maybe any old hero of either one of yours that man, it'd be great to go in, you know, like you do in the Hendrix, the Stone Free thing. Is there anybody like that you would say, man, it'd be great to do a whole album of their stuff?
Mm. You know? I don't know about an album's worth necessarily. You know, just off the top of my head, I mean, boy, wouldn't it be great to cover some Stone stuff? Wouldn't it be great to have done some Elvis stuff?
Or some John Lennon and...
You know, to work with the various people that, you know, you'd love to still work with.
Sure.
Know?
Absolutely. Mike, thanks. Good question. Thanks, Renee is in Memphis, Tennessee, listening to Rock 103 tonight. Renee.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Hello, Renee. How are you?
Congratulations, Richie.
Oh, thank you very much.
I got two quick questions. The first one is, I've been hearing rumors about Al leaving the band. Is that true? And the other is, John, why weren't you at the Elvis tribute?
I wasn't at the Elvis tribute. Boy, next question, please. That's true. I wasn't at the Elvis tribute. I just finished a movie, and I was stuck up in Canada. Well, I wasn't stuck. I was happily stuck up on the set of the film, and couldn't get away. And we're making some moves. So I'll keep you up to date on that.
Film at 11 then, or
yeah, it could be.
All right. We'll leave it at that then. Renee, Jeffrey is in Anchorage, Alaska, listening to 106.5 KWL in Anchorage. Jeffrey,
hi Richie, hi John.
Hey man, how's Alaska? Any snow yet?
Oh, it snowed a little bit this morning.
Oh man,
come on back up and do another gig, will you?
Defect, buddy, defect.
We did three gigs up there last time we were up there. It was wild.
Now wait a minute. You guys go to sleep. You know it's 1 a.m. and it's still light out. How do you explain that?
We rock the world.
There you
must.
Go.
You guys just go, well, I don't have to come home until the streetlights are on, right?
You got that right.
Be up for 3 months.
Yeah.
So.
Unbelievable.
Jeffrey, what's your question?
I hear you recently both recorded together on a George Gershwin song. Can you tell us about it?
Yeah, George Martin, the guy who produced the Beatles, which was, he's a living legend, asked if we would take part in this album. And I couldn't, pass that opportunity up. So while we were in England, I sang the track and had Richie come in and play the guitar solo on it. Just for the idea of playing with George Martin producing, just for history's sake.
They're finding out the Beatles secrets.
Yeah, and that was the deal. We'll do it if you tell us Beatles.
We don't want to get paid. We just want to find out all the old Beatles secrets.
Just give us Beatles stories. That's great. Jeffrey, thank you much. John, before we go to break, I just want to make sure that we have not either left things unclear or too clear, but the situation with Alec John Such, do we need to elaborate on that? Somebody called and asked if he's leaving the band, and...
He may be.
Okay.
Yeah, he may be.
All right. All right, we will be our return, and we will have more with John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora and more of your phone calls and more live playing. Stick around on the Global Satellite Network. Next Monday night, get ready for a very spooky Halloween edition of Shockline, if you will. That's right. No tricks here, folks. Instead, we're going to treat you to a frightfully entertaining show featuring some of the great bands on the Black Sabbath tribute CD called Nativity in Black. So how's this for a Halloween lineup? Megadeth, White Zombie, Faith No More, Type O Negative, Ugly Kid Joe, and members of Black Sabbath themselves. To tribute to the ultimate Halloween band, Black Sabbath, next Monday night, exclusively on Interactive Radio, Rockline. Steve Downs, along with John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora in our Hollywood Rockline studios tonight. I alluded to not only, John, are there two new tracks on the album, but there's also a reworking of Living on a Prayer, which is, I think, a great rendition of this. And I was wondering maybe if you might play it tonight.
Sure.
Let's do it.
Sure. Okay, Mook.
Mm-hmm.
the docks. The union went on strike, but down on his luck. It's tough.
It's tough.
It's tough. Gino was a diner all day.
Yes, it's tough.
Working for a man to bring some of pay for love.
For his love.
Shot, whoa, if we there,
oh,
take my hand, we'll make it, I swear, yeah,
living on a prayer.
Shadow cast he used to talk so true. Gina Jean's running away.
Yes, she does.
When she cries every night, Tommy whispers, hey, Gina, it's okay. Someday they say we gotta hold on to what we.
It's called on Crossroad. We heard it live here on Rockline tonight with John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora. Very, very nice. Back to the phones we go now. Julie is in Delta Township, Michigan this evening listening to Q106 in Lansing. Julie?
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi, John. Hi, Richie. How you guys doing?
Very well. And how are you?
Oh, pretty good.
Good.
I was wondering why you decided to redo Living on a Prayer.
It was a lyric that still touched home with us. I thought that a lot of people related to that song through the years, and we wanted to reinvent it, give it another go-around, and on this format, you know, we thought it was worth it.
Yeah, I was going to say, not only does it still say something for you, which was obvious from the way you performed it in the studio here tonight, but it still is a very relevant lyric.
You know,
out there for a lot of people. Danny is listening to 96 Rock in Atlanta. He's in Douglasville, Georgia tonight. Danny?
Hi, I'm a girl. Hi, guys.
Hi, Danny.
Danny would be a girl for any of you taking notes there. But
I saw you a few years ago in Germany, and I was wondering, I have two questions. What inspires you guys? Because a lot of the stuff you do is very down home and, you know, speaks to me. And the second is, when are you touring in Atlanta?
I think we'll be in Atlanta before you know it. Don't be surprised if you see us before too long. And inspiration?
I think it comes from our life experience, possibly, and then possibly all the stuff that we see touring all over the world. You know, you talk to a lot of people and you see a lot of things and the newspapers. It's just the times, I think, the way you feel about things is going to inspire you, you know, the way you feel about things.
Do you see, in terms of subject matter, a change of direction in the stuff that you're writing now opposed to?
Oh, yeah. It's a lot more socially relevant, I think, than the things we were writing early on. You know, fortunately and unfortunately, we were so young when we got a recording contract that the history that you had to draw upon was high school. You know, it was like the biggest thing you did in your life was, you know, graduated high school.
You knew how to do was go out with girls and wipe your butt.
Well, there's an album maybe, but...
Yeah, no, there's subject matter, but, you know, as albums progress and you grow and you grow and you grow, you know, and things happening and your life changes, you know, it's a lot of things come into play and you start, you know, thinking of other things to write about. That's what's happening to us now.
Right. Kim is in Wausau, Wisconsin this evening, listening to 95.5 WIFC. Hey, Kim.
Hey.
Hi.
Hey.
Peace,
guys.
Peace on you, sister.
My question
get off
is,
that phone. Oh, no. Hurry up.
It's okay. It's only
but,
natural radio.
I have to say that I think you were two of the greatest singers and guitarists ever.
Thank you. That's very kind of you. What, 2-3 years?
At least. Yeah, at least down the road. Yeah, the band is definitely taking the forefront. It always did, actually. So, I mean, you know, that's where you have the most fun when you share it with everyone.
All right, and Richie, the same with you in terms of a solo project. That's back burner at this point.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I thought it was for me, actually. I thought it was for both of us.
Hey,
man.
All right, this next track, and I sort of alluded to this earlier on, when this song, when Runaway came out, there was no Bon Jovi band.
True.
I mean, you talk about doing it, you know, the reverse. What were you doing at the time, John, when that song...
In the early 80s in New Jersey, if you were in a cover band, that's bands that play other people's music, you could really make a great living. And until the drinking age changed in Jersey, cover bands were making a fortune, like many thousands of dollars a night playing AC/DC and Led Zeppelin and all the major rock songs. We had clubs there that could hold like 3,000 people in New Jersey where I lived. And so I didn't play cover songs from the time I was, I don't know, 17 or 18 years old. So playing in an original band or writing songs, you were lucky to get $100 a night. And so to keep a band together was impossible. Mm. At this time in 1982, when I wrote this, it was very difficult. It was nearly impossible. And I had a bunch of studio guys play on the record. It was Roy Bittan from Bruce Springsteen's E Street Band and Frankie LaRocca, who is now an A&R guy, but was once a great drummer, and, you know, all these different guys playing on the tracks. And what happened was is a radio station in New York that is now non-existent. I went to a DJ because I thought DJs, more than any guy in the record business, must really love music because they sit in a little room by themselves talking into a microphone, spinning vinyl, you know, and they're reaching the masses, but as far as they're concerned, they're only talking to themselves, you know? So I went and I knocked on this radio station door and I says, look, I'm having no luck getting a record deal. I'm frustrated. Listen to this and tell me if it's worth anything. And the jock put it on a homegrown record, convinced me to put it on there. and it broke all kinds of rules because it started to break nationally without a record deal. And that got me a record deal, and then I put the band together.
So it was song, record deal, band.
Fact.
In that order.
Yes, sir.
Bon Jovi on Rockline. That's where it all started, back in 1984, Runaway from Bon Jovi. John and Richie Sambora with us tonight on Rockline. And Melissa is in Meridian, Connecticut, listening to 106 WHCN in Hartford tonight. Melissa.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Melissa. How are you, honey?
Good. I just want to say you guys are the sweetest in the world, and it's a real pleasure to talk to you.
Give you a cavity. We're so sweet. You better watch out.
My question is for the both of you. You've seen the success that you've had with Always. And what do you think contributed to the fact that Bon Jovi is really one of the last bands of the 80s to still be accepted in the mainstream?
We won't live!
Like, we're like that bad drunk thing. You gotta go home now.
Like, Grandpa won't go.
That's right. I don't know, darling. We just, we keep writing them, and thanks to guys like you that keep listening to them, we're still here. So, and we don't plan on going anywhere quick, that's for sure.
Great.
Thank you, though.
Trina is in Maumille, Arkansas, listening to Magic 105 in Little Rock tonight. Trina.
Hey, how are you guys doing?
Hi.
Good. I've seen you guys probably about six times since 1984, and you guys always sound so good in concert. I was wondering if you have, like, any kind of a vocal warm-up that you do before you go on.
We scream at each other.
Yeah, we scream at each other over the music that's usually playing in the dressing room. What do you want the set to be tonight? I don't know. What do you want it to be? And then you know.
Wow.
that was Richie's imitation of a...
Fascinating, Richie.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Multi-talented.
Really, actually, you know, John Lennon taught me that when I was a wee lad.
There isn't really much of a deal, hon. It's just a lot of years of being out there on the road.
Thanks, Trina, for the call. Forget to send in your postcards for your chance to win one of our 94 Rockline AT&T calendars that are signed by the guests that appear on the show during the month of October. To be eligible to win, put your name, address, and the station you're listening to right now on a postcard. Mail it to 1994 Rockline Calendar, P.O. Box 4383, Hollywood, California, 90078. The 94 Rockline Calendar.
Or send me $5.
Or $5. It's brought to you by AT&T. We help put your world within reach. We'll be back. Remind that you that everyone who gets on the air tonight with either Richie or John will receive their very own copy of Crossroad, the brand new Bon Jovi Greatest Hits package that includes 14 classic grooves, as it says, courtesy of the generous folks at Mercury Records. We head back to the phones now. Sault Ste. Marie, Michigan is our next stop. Wings FM in Lapeer is the station. Jeff, you're on with John and Richie.
Hi, bud.
Hey, first of all, I want to thank you guys for all the great stuff you put out over the years. It's really helped me through a lot of rough spots.
Thank you.
And my question is, I heard Richie's solo album, I heard John's solo album, I thought they were both great. And I was wondering, with Crossroads and the new direction for the band, are we going to be seeing more of a two-vocal stance like some bands like Kiss have done with, you know, John leading some songs, Richie leading others?
The Beatles did that, didn't they?
I think they did once or twice, yeah.
The Beatles did it, yes.
I think that you'll see some more, maybe not Richie singing and then me singing, but a lot more duetting, I guess you'd say. You know, it seems that's the way some of the new songs are shaping up, which is pretty interesting because we've never done that before. But we were thinking more like the Stones, and when Keith...
She's got a mind of her own, and she uses it well, yeah. One of a kind.
I wish you could see this, folks. Richie's doing his best Keith impersonations, all the moves.
All the impressions you do, Richie. I had no idea. We've had Dylan Lennon and now Keith Riley.
Steady.
The schizophrenic Richie Sambora.
That's right. There's 16 of me in here, and I'm a dangerous.
And it's a mighty small studio. Jeff, thanks. Cora is in Serenia, Ontario, listening to 101 FM WRAF in Detroit. Cora.
Hi, it's Sarnia.
Sarnia, thank you.
Hi, guys. You guys, I just need to say that you guys are the bedrock of rock. And my question is...
Wilma!
What do you think about Malcolm Jones' book, Faith and Glory? And how has he been connected to the band in order to write the book? And how much truth does it hold?
Well, Malcolm is a good friend. And to be honest with you, it's factually incorrect.
He lied a lot.
He lied a lot. You know, he didn't do a great job. It wasn't an authorized biography, but it wasn't so unauthorized that we didn't see it, and we tried to tell him all the mistakes in it. But it's factually incorrect, to be honest with you. He remains a good friend and a big supporter, but, well, I guess somebody else, you know, we'll get somebody to write the authorized one in another 10 years or so.
Is that something that you would see down the road, something you'd like to do or have done?
You know, right now, what are you going to write about? There's, you know, I mean, it's been some amazing things, but in essence, you know, I mean, I look to the Stones and you go, that's when you write a book. You know, it's 30 years, not 10 years. Yeah. We've just gotten our feet wet.
All right, Cora.
Thank you.
Someone, and I don't know if this is, lady by the name of Kansas, who lives in Lake Michigan, who's listening to 93.3 KQZ in Flint. Kansas?
Yeah. Hi.
Hi.
I just wanted to say you guys are really great, and I love listening to your music. And my question is for you, are you guys going to be doing an anniversary show in New Jersey?
An anniversary show? No, what we do there is these Christmas shows every year for the last, well, this will be the fifth, charity Christmas shows, even, you know, if we're on the road, if we're not on the road. So we'll be back there in Jersey playing a small show this year in our hometown.
Was it this year that you were part of the Stone Pony anniversary? Was that this year or is time slipping
away?
Yeah,
no, it was. Yeah, what was it, their 20th?
With Bruce and Southside Johnny.
Yeah,
and,
all
the guys.
Yeah,
How was that?
Oh, you know, it's always a thrill to play with those guys and to see those guys and just, you know, have a beer. You know, growing up, I'm a, you know, I'm a lot younger than those guys. But those are, you know, those were my heroes growing
sure.
up. So now, you know, having made records and then actually befriending those guys, you know, it's that was all I ever wanted to do was you know, grow up and be a juke.
So, absolutely.
You know, that was it for me.
Yeah. All right, Kansas, thanks for the call. You guys have been working on a couple of things here tonight for our next live selection, and I'm not sure which one you've decided.
Me either.
What are we playing?
Actually, I would like to know what we're playing.
Yeah, I know. We're trying to sit here and think what we should do so that you know that these things aren't rehearsed. The most hardcore fan will know this song, but anyone else won't because we're actually finally considering putting it on an album, but it's something that's been in the mix for a while. It's maybe a bit of the new direction.
You started, I'll meet you at the break.
Recognizable, as John said, to hardcore Bon Jovi fans, and also recognizable to hardcore Rockline fans because you did that
song a couple years back.
That's right, a couple years ago. That's okay.
You know, it's funny because we wrote that song years ago, and
but it really pertains to me now.
This week is yours. That's right. On New Jersey, when we wrote it for New Jersey, it fit where my head was at. You see, when I was going through and about to get married, and yet it didn't fit the album. It just didn't work right. And then with Keep the Faith, we re-recorded it, wrote the new bridge to it, did it again, listened to it, and said, this is just not working. And where we are now and what's gone on in our lives and where we're headed, you know, collectively, because when I say me, I mean we. He's getting married.
Yeah, that's right.
Was for you.
It fits. So it fits it really makes sense this time. Yeah. And so it's truly in the running. It's down to the final.
That's a great song. Yeah. Richie, by the way, is there a date yet?
Steady.
No. We're very happy, but we haven't exactly have a date yet.
Okay. All right. There you go. Our next call is from Dayton, Ohio. Tracy is listening to 104.7 WTUE. Tracy.
Hi, guys.
What's up, Trace?
Not much. My question is, with the band settling down and getting married the way they are, is that going to change the way you guys are going to tour in the future?
I don't think so. We've got an extensive tour being planned right now that I think will take us well into 95. Right through 95, come to think of it. No, I don't think it's going to settle anything down for quite a while.
All right, Tracy. Janie is in New Orleans tonight listening to 99.5 WRNO FM. Janie?
How y'all doing?
Hey, baby.
How y'all doing, Janie?
Love your voices, Richie.
Awesome.
I got a question for you on your Stranger in This Town album.
Strangler in My Garage.
Yeah. Where did you get the inspiration for the answer?
Ooh, the answer started. I started to write that with a pal of mine when I was about 19 years old, and I didn't finish it till I was 31. So it was one of those songs that were a very evolutionary kind of thing. I think that song is a very heavy one. It kind of has a lot of philosophy in it and some stuff like that. So,
all right, Janie, good question. Carrie is in Worcester, Mass. tonight, listening to 94HJY in Providence, Rhode Island. Carrie, you're on Rockline.
Hi, Rich. Hi, John.
Hi, Ann.
Hey.
A lot of great history in Providence. Love that town.
I just wanted to know, how come you have the song Edge of a Broken Heart on the single, but you don't have it on the cassette?
It didn't fit. It was another one of those songs that, it was never even on an album of ours, but it was something here in America that became one of those hardcore fan kind of songs because it was on a soundtrack. And it was a leftover song from Slippery. Well, that one, like I said, Born to Be My Baby, Living in Sin, Never Say Goodbye. I wanted to put Miracle from the Young Guns record, Stranger in This Town from Richie's solo record. All those songs we couldn't fit on this volume one, I guess, you know.
Wasn't that on the Fat Boys soundtrack or something?
It was a Fat Boys movie called The Disorderlies. Yeah.
Becky is in Palmdale, California tonight, listening to 93.5 KLKX. Hey, Becky.
Hey, guys.
Hi, Beck.
Hi.
I was kind of curious, what kind of advice do you have for a female guitarist interested in getting into rock?
Well, basically, I think that your listening skills have to be up. You have to listen to a lot of different music because a musician listens to music like a writer would read books. You know, so you should listen with your ears and then, practice a bit and try to apply what you've learned listening to the guitar if you can, and then also play with as much emotion and feel as you can, because you can make one note sing and mean more than 50 notes if you... So it doesn't take a whole lot of technique if you don't really need to have that.
Yeah. Good advice there, Becky. I take that to heart. We've talked a little bit about both of you in terms of the individual solo things that you have done away from the band, and both of them, you know, were very successful. Usually when that happens, one of the things that happens is the band sort of either gets put on the back burner or disappears altogether. That's the exact opposite of what happened with you guys, and you brought the band back. Tell me about those times in the basement after Young Guns 2 and after Stranger in This Town. What were the discussions that went on there?
It wasn't a question of would the band continue. It was there was other elements that were playing on our emotions. You know, it was just the drain of Slippery and New Jersey back-to-back and the tours being back-to-back that exhausted us. So it led to our going on that hiatus, and when we came back, it was like, oh God, I just don't want to start this machine the way it was. Mm-hmm. And we had to figure out what was it that was driving us crazy, and it wasn't the five of us, it was the machine that ran it, you know. And so once we eliminated that, it got back to basics. But for my own experience with the Guns record, as much of a you know, experience, a wonderful experience it was, what we've always been able to do is whenever a record reaches number one or you have some great successes with it, you'd call each other, you'd have a party, you'd high five, you'd go buy a beer. Well, it was very strange because I got that phone call and there wasn't anyone to share it with. See, and that was a very, you know, lonely experience at the end of the day. You know, I mean, it's pretty neat to have guys that were there in the garage that were there in the stadium.
Right.
You know, that's a nice thing.
From Young Guns 2, John Bon Jovi, Blaze of Glory. John is with us along with Richie Sambora tonight, and when we come back, more of your phone calls and some more live playing coming up on the Global Satellite Network. Richie Sambora and John Bon Jovi are with us live all over North America tonight on Rockline.
I love Mokey Bagger. He loved me.
Well, there you have it. Suzanne is in Brandon, Manitoba, listening to KX 96 FM, Kix 96 FM. Suzanne?
Hey, John, Richie. How are you guys doing tonight?
Hi, honey. How you doing?
Hey, dear.
Yeah, I'm pretty good. Hey. So for your new album coming out in the spring of 95, is it just you two working on the album, like writing songs for it, or is there other members of the band going in on it?
None of the other guys have any writing on this record.
We's like Simon and Garfunkel, man.
Funny you should mention that.
That's right. No, Dave and Tico aren't doing any writing on this record, no. Unfortunately, but Richie and I have done the share. We've done it.
Quite prolific.
There you go. Cheryl is in Orlando, Florida tonight, listening to Rock 100 WDIZ. Cheryl?
Hi, what do you guys think of today's music scene, and do you listen to any alternative bands?
Yeah, sure we do. You know, we're not under a rock. No, I like a whole bunch of stuff that's going on out there.
I like that band Soundgarden and Pearl Jam. I love them.
Arnold is here with us.
Yeah, Arnold. Yeah, right.
What do I like? I like everything that's going on out there right now. There's quite a few things. Nine Inch Nails record is great. Mm-hmm. What else have I been listening to?
Jeff Buckley. I've been listening to Jeff Buckley.
Candlebox. Collective Soul.
Yeah. If we keep going, Richie's going to name them all. There's a lot of them out there, that's for sure. You know, but the interesting thing, and I think it was you that said this, now as back in 84 and 85, you know, the band, I mean, the way you see it, the band's not fashionable. They just keep making good music.
That's right. Yeah. We're so unfashionable that we are fashionable.
That's right.
You know what I mean? When it gets to a situation where, like, everybody, like, your teacher comes in, he looks like he's from Seattle, and then, you know, those poor guys that come from Seattle, they're going, oh, man, enough already. Yeah. And then, you know, it's like when Slippery was huge, A&R guys, every record company ran out and signed 10 Bon Jovis. And,
right.
You know, it happened to bands after us, it'll happen to bands before us, and it'll happen to, you know, these bands now, but the Pearl Jams and Nirvanas and Soundgardens have been duplicated and imitated 100 times over, and the strong will eventually survive you know.
Dave is in Glen Gardner, New Jersey tonight, listening to Z95 in Allentown, Pennsylvania. Dave, you're on with Richie and John.
Hey, guys, what's up?
I'm a Jersey guy. What's up?
Yeah. John, I was wondering if you remember where you got your Superman tattoo done.
Right here in Hollywood, California.
Did you really?
Yes, sir, in Sunset Boulevard. What's it called? Sunset Tattoos?
Sunset Tattoos, yes.
Yes, sir. Yeah. I went in there to get a thing that would resemble the motorcycle club's patch, and it was, you know, to be tattooed on my arm. It was going to say Bon Jovi, New Jersey, and the guy said, well, if you happen to run into anybody, like, from that gang, and you're not a member, they might rip your arm off and beat you with the wet end of it. All right, so here I am, like, wearing some gang's colors, you know, and I said, that's a good idea. I'll take the little Superman thing next to it.
Superman's cool with it, I think.
Yeah,
so.
He's cool. He can handle.
Yeah, he can handle.
He's only in the movies, right? Right. Okay, good. I'll take that. You know, it was one of those things many years ago.
You guys have been sort of fooling around with something here during the show, and
how do you humiliate yourself on that?
Richie mentioned Simon and Garfunkel. I mean, you want to give it a whirl
sure,
here?
Yeah, I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
We'll try it. No problem.
Outstanding. Outstanding. Bridge Over Troubled Water, the great Simon and Garfunkel classic there. Done great. Man, that was
that's a matter of interpretation.
You did it. That was great. John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora live exclusively on Rockline. Outstanding.
You like a challenge.
Man, you rose to it.
You know what the best part of it was? Like a bridge over troubled waters, I will read your mind. That was my favorite. And it was my fault too, so I will take the blame.
Oh man, that was great. Lisa is in Indianapolis tonight listening to Q95. Lisa, what'd you think?
Hi, I thought it was great. How are you guys doing?
Hi, Lisa. What's happening?
I'll read your mind, Lisa. Go ahead. Just put the phone up to your mind, and I will read it like a bridge over troubled water.
Go for it. Listen, I got a question for you guys. I was wanting to know with the release of Crossroad, if you guys would be like on a solo act with no band opening up for you, and if Richie would do anything from a stranger in this town.
Yeah, it's a nice idea. We usually do those Christmas shows, and that has crossed our paths. We've been doing those kind of things, which started at the end of our last tour. But we're not going to be touring until next summer, and at that time, I guess we'll make the decision if there's going to be an opening band, and if there is, who it will be, and what the set will be, because it's really never the same twice.
John and I are going to do a trapeze act. Actually, we'll be, you know,
whipping out above the stand, selling popcorn prior to the show.
That's right. Without a net, I assume. Is there any other way? Lisa, thank you very much. And we will be back with more from John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora coming up on the Global Satellite Network. Quick thanks to everyone for listening and for calling in tonight. Next Monday night, it's a special Halloween edition of Rockline, or as we like to call it, Shockline, featuring a tribute to the ultimate Halloween band, Black Sabbath. Joining us next Monday for fun and frivolity will be White Zombie, Megadeth, Faith No More, Ugly Kid Joe, Bruce Dickinson, Type O Negative, and quite possibly some of the guys from the original Black Sabbath themselves. Special thanks tonight to Paul Corzilius, to Dave Davis for their very special help this evening, to Michael Eidlis and Drew Murray, Tony Smith, and Lori Countner of Mercury Records, and finally to our guests tonight, Richie Sambora and John Bon Jovi. Guys, as always, it's a ball to have you here.
Say goodnight, Dick.
Goodnight, Dick. Steve Downs.
See you.